Hare 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 प्रभु अपीयरेंस डे महामहोत्सव की अनंत कोटि वैष्णव की जय गौर सीतानाथ मान जय ऑल ग्लोरी टू द सुमति ओ कृष्णा ऑल ग्लोरी टू द सुमति ओ कृष्णा ऑल ग्लोरी टू द सुमति ओ कृष्णा ऑल ग्लोरी टू श्री गुरु श्री गौरांग प्रभु श्री प्रभुपाद जय श्री गुरु ओम अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कथामहं वंदेहं श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरु वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सनातनगुणातान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिगणसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादा सहगणरमिता श्रीविशाखाभिकांक्षा हे कृष्णा करुणा सिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेशा गोपिकाकान्ता राधाकान्ता नमोऽस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वाचा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येन च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामी नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवासी पाश्चात्यदेशचारिणे जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैता गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे हरे Hare Krishna. So today is as usual auspicious day, very auspicious day, because we are celebrating two occasions today. What are they? Today happens to be Varaha Dwadashi and Nityananda Trayodashi, because tomorrow is actually Chaturdashi and Trayodashi is missing in between. Today is Dwadashi and tomorrow is Chaturdashi. So in between Trayodashi is missing. So that Trayodashi is actually in the night, but in ISKCON temple they celebrate Nityananda Trayodashi tomorrow. Since ours is a Sunday center, we are going to celebrate it today. So we will try to hear, how many of you like past tense? All of us like past tense. How many of you like philosophy? Not so much. Not everyone likes philosophy on a Sunday evening. Okay? So let's actually hear more pastimes. We will try to actually hear more. One from Varahadev appearance. Today is Varahadev appearance day. And also, so there are two Varahadevs. Does anyone know who are they? Which Varahadev is this Varahadev we are talking about? Shweta Varaha. Right? So somebody does home at home, they say Shweta Varaha Kalpe. Right? You all heard about that? So this earth had fallen into the ocean. Which ocean? Atlantic Ocean. Which ocean did it fall into? Not Karana. Garbhodaka Ocean. Yes. So we'll try to understand a little more about How did it go there? How can a whole planet, the earth, go under some...
Hiranyaksha.
Yes, but Hiranyaksha, how did you put it there? It's going down actually, so can you... Yes, yes, this is good. Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you so much. So you all, how many of you know about Hiranyaksha? Hiranyakashipu? Oh, most of you know. Okay. Some of you don't know. Okay. I'll briefly tell you the background around these two demons. They're very, very demoniac people. Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu. The name itself is, they're brothers. They're twins. Interestingly, they were actually the doorkeepers of Narayana. They were Jaya and Vijaya. Jaya and Vijaya are the doorkeepers of Vaikuntha. Dwarpal, they are actually, they don't allow anyone to get inside. They are the maintenance of Vaikuntha planets. Somehow, the four Kumaras actually are sons of Brahmaji. And they were visiting, they were just walking. They were they are highly transcendental. They were just walking here and there. They entered the Vaikuntha world. So when they reached the place, the doorkeeper stopped them, saying that, you are not actually having a love of Krishna, you cannot enter this place. So these Kumaras became offended. They were very angry. Nobody has stopped us. We don't have any desires. Actually, they were not devotees of the Lord. They were impersonalists. They were Brahman realized. For them, everything is one. That kind of people. So they cannot enter, such kind of people cannot enter Vaikuntha. To enter Vaikuntha, you need to have a loving attitude. Just like if somebody actually is coming to your house, unless until you know that person and you have a relationship with that person, you will not allow that person to come inside the house, right? But they can roam around your house, but they cannot enter inside. Similarly, these Kumaras were very great personalities, but they didn't have a loving affection towards Vishnu. So they were not allowed to enter inside. When Jayavijayan stopped them, this Kumara became angry. He said, you people don't know how to respect a saint. So I curse you to leave the Vaikuntha world and go. They always send to which place? Bhumiloka. So we are all very, very fortunate to be here. You are very great personalities to be in the material world, especially in the earth. So, but then they started begging. So before they started begging the Kumaras, Vishnu himself came. Vishnu understood, my servants have made a mistake. So it's my responsibility to protect them. So he came out. When he came out, these Kumaras saw such a personality for the first time. He was transcendental. You are not made of flesh. They had seen bodies made of flesh, but they never seen someone so attractive. And at the lotus feet of the Lord, they had tulsi patta, or even leaf of tulsi. That smell of tulsi attracted the Kumaras. And the Kumaras started looking at the lotus feet of the Lord. All of them are very short, very small. They are brahmacharis, but very, what do you call, like 5-year-old, 6-year-old boys. They are that small. They went around Lord's lotus feet and they started looking at, what is this? It is so attractive. We are liberated and we have no attraction in this creation. Why are we getting the attraction of this tulsi? So when they saw this, then Vishnu actually blessed them. So they started becoming devotees. Then the Jaya and Vijaya came and said, my Lord, we made a mistake. What to do? He said, don't worry. I will give you one benediction. You want to be my devotees for 100 births in the material world or 3 births as my enemies. But you will not remember that you are enemies. Which one you prefer? So Jaya and Vijaya said, immediately 3 births is better. Who will go there? Horrible place, and we are very proud of this place, right? You want to make this heaven. So that's how they came in. The first birth, Jaya became Hiranyaksha and Vijaya became Hiranyakashipu. Then the second birth, they actually appeared as Ravana and Kumbhakarna. And third, Shishupala and Dantavakra. All of them are killed by Vishnu. First time, Hiranyaksha was killed by Hiranyaksha, so, and then Hiranyakashipu by Narsingadeva. So first let's actually only focus on Hiranyaksha. So this Hiranyaksha, he understood that as soon as he was born, of course, the birth of Hiranyaksha Hiranyakashipu also was very mystical, because Kashyapa Muni was meditating and Diti heard that Adityas were born. Aditi actually gave birth to so many Adityas, like Soma, Agni, all of them were actually born out of Aditi. Kashyapa had two wives, Diti and Aditi. Aditi actually had all the Adityas, Devatas, and Diti actually had all the Daityas. Daitya, Dhanavas, all of them, all demoniac people. Imagine, mother is coming and then all the children actually are Rakshasas. Ah, kind of. But anyway, so this is all transcendental for us to understand. So Diti became very impatient. Your other wife actually has so many children and you are not giving me any child. This is unfair. And in the evening, when you actually do Sandhya, in the Sandhya time, this is actually the Sandhya time, we are supposed to do Aarti. Like this is what we are doing. But Diti wanted a child. So Kashyapa Muni said, this is a very dangerous time to have a child. Diti said, no, I am impatient. I want a child now. So Kashyapa Muni said, okay, I'll give you, but then don't blame me. Because this time Lord Shiva goes around with all his... Who goes with the Lord Shiva? Ghosts. All Bhutaganas. And if somebody actually is engaging in a sexual activity, one of the ghosts will go and enter the womb. Imagine you'll have a very nice child after that. Right? Meant for doing very nice activities in the world. You have a very demoniac personality coming out. That's how Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu were born. They are twins. And since Hiranyakashipu was actually conceived first, he came later. Hiranyaksha was conceived next, so he came first. Last in, first out. Out of the womb, right? So that is why Hiranyakashipu is elder to Hiranyaksha. Hiranyaksha came out, and when he came out, he created a big mess. He was actually against all the devatas. He was fighting with the devatas from day one. He knew that actually if you want to become powerful, I need to pray and get the power. So he went to pray. He meditated on Brahmaji. And Brahmaji gave him, your body will be like thunderbolt. If you can go, nobody can stand in front of you. Go ahead, go do whatever you want. And he disappeared. And Hiranyaksha started carrying havoc. He went to all the places. He couldn't go to Vaikuntha, but he went all the places. Everywhere he went and roamed around. He heard that of all the devatas, Varuna Dev is very powerful. So he went into the ocean. He was dipping, he was actually going around here and there. He went all the way down, right, to Varuna's abode. Varuna is the god of rain, or not rain, ocean. So he went there and then he knocked on the door of Varuna Dev and then said, Varuna Dev, I'm a servant, I'm a very humble person. I want to fight. Come, let's fight. So Varuna Dev said, this person is very arrogant, right? I know I can't fight with him because he has the blessings of Brahma. I can't defeat him. But he controlled his anger. He said, I'm very old. The only person who can fight with you is Vishnu. Go search Vishnu and fight with him. Then he came out of water and he actually went around. He went to Narad Muni. Somehow Narad Muni comes. Narad Muni actually appears wherever nice things have to happen. He's a great personality. Actually, in our Hindu mythology, so-called mythology, Narad Muni is actually portrayed as a very bad person, as someone who actually creates a lot of problems. He is not like that, actually. He is the embodiment of devotional service, bhakti. He brings bhakti in people. You know who his disciples are? Prahlad Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj, right? All these great personalities are his disciples. So he went and told, what are you doing, Hiranyaksha? You wanted Vishnu, no? Yeah, I want to see Vishnu. Where is he? You will not be able to see him. He has to come and appear in front of you. Tell me, how will he appear? Do this, this, this. Kill cows. What? Done. Torture women. Okay. Kill brahmanas. Automatically, he will come out of hiding. So, he started doing this for many years. But Vishnu did not appear. He was frustrated to the core. He thought, He went again to Narad Muni and asked, like, what is I'm doing all this thing but Vishnu is not coming. Then he said, there's one more way that you can do. All devatas actually sustain because of the yajnas done in the earth. If that is stopped, all the devatas will die. For protecting the devatas, Vishnu will come. Then you can see Vishnu. He said, wow, that is a singer. How do we stop everything? The easiest way that you can stop is don't provide opportunity. So he thought, where should I put? And Vishnu is actually very pure. So I should put him in some place. I should put the whole earth in some place that even Vishnu can't go on. So he took the earth and put into the Garbhodaka ocean. He actually messed with the internals of the earth, core of the earth. He was so powerful. He actually drilled out everything. They say actually he drilled out all the gold. So the earth became very light. So he went and fell into the Garbhodaka ocean. So he went very deep. So all the demigods became weak and started crying out for help. They all went to Brahmaji. So Brahmaji is transcendental. He doesn't get disturbed by all these things. So but he was meditating, what do I do? Because what is bottom of the ocean? What will be there in the bottom of the ocean normally? Earth will be there? No. All the fishes will go for poop, no? All will be there. It'll be filled. The bottom of the ocean will be actually all the dirty things, dead material, right? All unwanted stuff. Anything you drop, it will go down, right? All dirty things will be there. Nobody will go there. It's very, very dirty. So Brahma was thinking, I'm a Brahmana, what do I do? I don't know how to. He was meditating on Vishnu. Suddenly from his nostrils, one boar came, Varaha. Big form, right? Boar with big tusks, small one. Came out of his nostrils, came out and he started growing big, so big he became, and he started, water on his body, he started, when the dogs do, right, he started, he was kind of shriveling off all the water from his, shaking it off, so all the water actually started falling out. So when that water fell on the sages, they became very enlivened. They became very happy, very, very powerful. And immediately Brahmaji started understanding, and Vishnu understood, Brahmaji understood, this is not ordinary person, this is Vishnu. And he let out a big roar. When he actually roared, Hiranyaksha's heart was actually pounding. What is this sound? Where is it coming from? And Varahadev jumped into the water. When he jumped, the whole ocean divided into two. Huge waves came. He went inside all the way. Because the boar, the pig, is actually very expert in digging filth. All that halwa. He goes inside and then digs all this stuff. Right? So he's able to go. He went deeper into the ocean, lifted the earth, brought the earth up out of the Garbhodaka ocean. Hiranyaksha met him. Saw him, a thief, where are you taking the earth? If you have guts, fight with me first. So, but Lord wanted to put, because nobody else could do anything anyways, right? Because if the earth has to be actually protected, only the Lord can protect. Ordinary people cannot actually, even Brahmaji could not think of what to do, Lord Shiva could not do anything, Ganeshji could not do, because it's not easy to fight a demon like Hiranyaksha. So when he was trying to come out, Hiranyaksha stopped him. So the Lord actually was thinking, should I fight with them or put the earth in orbit? He thought first actually I should put the earth in orbit, because if they fight and then they smash the whole earth, it will be a big problem. Imagine if the Lord is lifting the earth, how big the Lord should be. And if Hiranyaksha is going to fight with the Lord, how big Hiranyaksha should be. Unimaginable for us, right? So, because this earth is actually the Punya Bhumi, like we all know it. The demigods, it's very important, because in one sense, you can do yajna here and then get out of the cycle of birth and death. You cannot do in the heavenly planets or in the hellish planets. Just like if you go on a retreat, you go on a trip to Dubai, you go on a trip to Dubai or some Singapore or something, do you actually go and do work to earn money there? You'll only spend. All the time you spend whatever money you have, you spend buy this, buy that, and go on a ride, this, that. Like that, if you go to the heavenly planets, you cannot earn anything. You can only spend everything. And once all the credits all over, come back. Shine punye, matyalakumashi. Chava under. So they have to go back. Right? So, that is why earth is very important. Because in earth you can do yajna and get out of the cycle of birth and death. So, Lord had to establish back. Now, the fight between Hiranyaksha and Varahadev is very nicely explained. I'll not get into the details, because it's one full chapter. They fight so nicely. The Lord fights in such a way that as if the demigods are watching, they want to support, they are the cheerleaders. They want to actually support Varahadev, but they are very scared. When actually Varahadev actually hits the Lord misses it. But he is holding the, what you call, earth on his tusks. And then he tries to dodge Hiranyaksha fighting. Then whenever Hiranyaksha is losing, the demigods actually all shout, very nice, very nice. So Hiranyaksha becomes very angry. You see like this, and all the demigods get scared. Right? So they're actually fighting like this, and then one point in time, Hiranyaksha actually hits so hard on the Lord takes his mace and then dodges it. So his mace falls off his hand, out of Varahadev's hand. So the demigods are very scared. And they tell him, don't give him this chance, because he's very dangerous, Hiranyaksha. Then Varahadev says, okay. And Brahmaji himself says, my lord, it's time. Don't play with him, it's too dangerous. Then Varahadev actually takes his paw hand and slightly hits on his cheek like this. Hiranyaksha's eyes pops out. his teeth, everything breaks apart. His skull breaks and he falls down dead. Then he puts the earth in orbit, and all of them actually come back and worship the Lord. That's actually the simplest way of telling Varahadev's story. So it's all so wonderful. Actually, there are details around how did he actually do these things and why did he actually take the form. And after that, the hair on his body, the boar actually has hair, right? Varahadev, those hair actually fall in different places, and that becomes Kushagras. You know Darbhagras? Kushagras? That becomes the Darbhagras is actually the Lord's. That's how it formed. So the sages become very happy that we got something. That's why they use that for all the yajnas. Without that, then nobody will do any yajna. So that's how Varahadev protected the earth. Mother Earth actually was back in its normal position. Varahadev ki jai. Because this earth is like a sulabh shauchale, very clean, right? It's like a toilet basically. But that doesn't mean that actually you should blow it off. But you should just leave this place. We should not stay here for long. It's not actually very nice. Even if you actually go and put scent in the toilet, toilet is still a toilet. Right? It's not actually very nice. Sometimes people, that is why the Westerners call it as restroom. Right? But it's not a restroom, it's a dirty place. You should just finish your work and get out of this place. So this place is like that. It's not for people to stay. Actually, why did the Lord come out of his nostril in the form of a boar? Because to tell Brahma, even though I'm a form of a boar, I'm still transcendental. You know, pig is a very dirty animal. What does it eat?
Stool.
Dirt? Yeah, kind of stool. Basically, it eats very dirty things. Right? And Brahmaji is a Brahmana. The top class Brahmana. And from Brahmana's body, a pig is coming. Right? Brahma was totally bewildered. Actually, he was confused. Like, what is happening? This is. So, but then the Lord wanted to prove, even though I'm actually a boar, even though I go and then touch the bottom of the ocean, still I'm transcendental, I'm worshipable. I'm not like ordinary pig on the road. So Varahadev is so very powerful. Varahadev Bhagwan ki jai. So we will actually talk a little about Lord Chaitanya's, Nityananda Prabhu's pastimes. So we are celebrating Trayodashi, Nityananda Trayodashi. Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Sri Advaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Sri Advaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Sri Advaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Sri Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself, and Nityananda Prabhu is Balaram, his first expansion. So they appeared in this world to give all the fallen conditioned soul an opportunity to become devotees, to go back to Krishna, to get liberated. So there was such magnificent personalities. No other incarnation. Varahadeva came. What did he do? He did not make anybody devotees as such. Narasimhadeva came. Only Prahlad was a devotee. Right? Lord Ram came. A few became devotees. When Krishna came, even after Arjuna heard Bhagavad Gita, he asked Krishna again. He didn't become so surrendered. He kept on asking Krishna, should I do this? Should I do that? But Lord Chaitanya appeared. He delivered everyone. Whoever heard about Lord Chaitanya, whoever is hearing about Lord Chaitanya, whoever will hear about Lord Chaitanya, will become devotees, will become very favorable to serve Krishna. That is the benediction of these great personalities. And Nityananda Prabhu is Adi Guru. Before you can actually, if you want to understand Radha and Krishna's pastimes, you need to actually get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. Without Lord Chaitanya's mercy, you cannot understand Radha and Krishna. And without getting the mercy of Lord Nityananda, you cannot approach Lord Chaitanya. Nityananda Prabhu is actually so merciful. So we'll try to hear a little more, some pastimes of Lord Nityananda Prabhu. Lord Nityananda Prabhu actually appeared in a place called Eka Chakra. You know where Eka Chakra is? Heard about? It's about 150 kilometers or 130 kilometers from Shidham Mayapur in Kolkata, not Kolkata, West Bengal. Eka Chakra means one wheel. So remember actually in the Mahabharata war, when Bhishma was actually shooting arrows at Arjuna, he said, Bhishma, he took the wheel of a chariot and started chasing Bhishma. He wanted to kill Bhishma. And Bhishma saw this and said, my lord, you're going to kill me. That's awesome. And he dropped everything. I'm not going to fight. Kill. I wanted you to kill me. Yes, if you kill me, I'll go back to God. I'll come back to you. But you're not going to kill me. Then Arjuna was very, very, very scared because Krishna had promised that I will not touch any weapon. I will not fight in this war. I will only advise. Arjuna was busy scared. So Arjuna actually caught hold of Krishna's waist from the back. But 100 cubic feet he dragged. Krishna dragged Arjuna for 100 cubic feet. That ferocious he was carrying and running. Then Arjuna pleaded, no, my lord, I will fight. I will fight with Bhishma. Don't worry. Please drop this. Don't become angry. Then Krishna, with all his anger, threw that wheel. And then just turned and came back. So when he threw that wheel actually fell into space. Called Eka Chakra. That's why it's called one wheel place, right? That's the same place in Mahabharata. Bhima killed a demon by name Bakasur. How many of you know this Bakasur? Yes. There's a bottle here. So if you feel like actually you'll like to eat like Bakasur, you can actually eat that place. What all which names people give for hotels, anyways. So this place, Nityananda Prabhu was actually appeared, and there were a lot of pastimes in that place. And incidentally, he was actually his father and mother was Hadai Oja and Padmavati. So they are his mother and father. He was born in a Brahminical family. From day one, he was actually very detached. He appeared before Lord Chaitanya appeared, long back. So he used to actually do a lot of pastimes, like Ramayana pastimes, right? He used to participate. He used to tell all the boys, this is how you have to do, this is how you have to do, this is how you have to play the pastime. One time actually, Nityananda Prabhu told how Lakshman got hit by the Indrajit's weapon and Lakshman fell down, right? And he had told everyone how this has to be done. So they were all playing, and then Nityananda Prabhu played the part of Lakshman. So one boy actually threw a flower at him, and that flower hit him, he fell down. And when he fell down, he became unconscious. So all the parents were actually coming and said, children, let's all go, it's all evening already, come. Nityananda Prabhu did not wake up. He was just lying down there. And then all the boys actually started crying, and everyone was very scared. What happened? What happened? Like this. So that point in time, suddenly the person who was playing the part of Hanuman realized Nityananda Prabhu had told him, you should get the Sanjeevani. And then get the one, what do you call it, he told him to actually get one flower and put it in my nose, then I'll wake up. Nobody knew it. So he remembered that and he got, so Hanuman went and got this, and then he took the flower and put it in his nose. And he then woke up. Hari Yuvavar. He woke up and saw and said, where is Hanuman? Where is Ram? Like that. So he was so enacting, I mean, he was so engrossed in the acting. So everyone was so thrilled. Right? Actually, in that place, as he grew up, there was a snake. That snake used to create a lot of problem. Why? Because you know this place where Kunti Maharani and the five Pandavas were staying, Bakasura used to eat one human being every day. Right? Every day one human being, one cart load of food. And one point in time, wherever this Kunti was staying, the host were Brahminical people. So in their house was a turn. Every family should set one person. That was their turn that day. And they were crying. They were all telling, we'll go, we'll go, we'll go like that. And Kunti actually saw this. Why are you all actually crying and discussing something? He said, Bakasura is there. You have to go. One of us have to go. They are all fighting. They will go. We don't know what to do. Kunti said, don't worry. I have five sons. I will send one of them. Said, he called Bhima. That time, Yudhishthira Maharaj and all the brothers had gone out except Bhima. Bhima was very hungry. I mean, he's overly hungry all the time, right? He has the vrika fire in his stomach. That's why it's called vrikodara. It burns like anything. Like, you have anything you put, it will burn. Right? So, he's always hungry. They told him, you have to take one cart load of food. I will go. Right? So, on the way itself, we went. One by one, he was eating like this. And then he was taking the cart, he was dying. One by one, he was eating like this and going. So, when he went there, Bakasura was waiting. Why are you so late? And things like that. Little bit was left and he started eating everything, finished everything, and Bakasura became angry. They both were fighting. So they fought for a long time. It was not easy to kill Bakasura. Even the demigod like Indra was finding difficult to defeat Bakasura. He was very powerful. So meanwhile Arjuna came, Yudhishthira came. Then Kunti said, your brother has actually gone to kill Bakasura. Arjuna was a little worried. It's not easy. In the night times actually the demons become more powerful. And my brother is not all that intelligent. He is very powerful to hit, but doesn't think so much. Right? So he released a Naga Astra that he had just received from Lord Shiva. So he released that Naga Astra on Bakasura. By the time Bhima had finished Bakasura. Bakasura finished. So that when the arrow reached that place, it's a Naga Astra. There was no target. Target is already gone. He didn't know what to do. So he was roaming around here and there. Right, so he's troubling all the children, elderly people were biting. So Nityananda came to know about it. This happened in Mahabharata time. After about 4,000 years, this Nityananda came. For 4,000 years, he tortured the snake. So Nityananda saw this. He said, this is very bad. We should not do this. So he took one of his earrings and put it in the hole of the snake, where the snake was there. The snake stayed there only, it couldn't come out. That's why Nityananda Prabhu have only one earring. This is for to just say that. Of course, not in this, but in the pictures you'll find he had only one earring. So he had put that earring inside the hole. So the snake started telling him, my lord, you are taking care of all of them. What about me? If you stay here, what will happen? Nobody will come. He said, don't worry, all of them will give you milk. They'll come and pour milk on you and they'll give all these fruits and things. Eat that and be happy inside. Right? So Then that's how both the problems were solved. Then Nityananda Prabhu actually had to move out. One sannyasi came and took him away on a yatra. So Nityananda Prabhu left Yaka Chakra. By the time Lord Chaitanya had appeared in Navadvip, when he actually left the place, Padmavati and Hadevaja became mad actually. They couldn't face the separation from Nityananda Prabhu, right? So Nityananda Prabhu actually is the embodiment of all mercy. Even Lord Chaitanya rejects, Nityananda Prabhu will not reject. In fact, as they grew up, when Lord Chaitanya actually started the Sankirtan movement was actually increasing. Lord Chaitanya actually had a strategy, preaching strategy, that time itself. What he did, he took the six Goswamis and said, you people go to the upper India, Uttar Pradesh, Vrindavan, Rajasthan, go and preach there. And he told Nityananda Prabhu, you go to the Bengal area. Okay? You preach in the Radhadesh. That is, Bengal is called Radhadesh. East Bengal and West Bengal together was called Radhadesh. So he used to go and preach there. And Lord Chaitanya himself said, I will go to the South India. And he would. So Lord Chaitanya had actually come here 500 years back in the South and we all missed him. Madhvacharya place. He had come to Udupi, he had come to actually south. Every place he came in the south. There's actually a Parikram Marg which actually came. He came and then gave everyone Krishna consciousness. And we all missed because we are not there. If we are there, you would have heard his holy name, you would have gone back. So we should at least take his instruction now. Chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And by that way, go back to God at this lifetime at least, right? So, that's all their preaching strategy. So, he did that. So, Lord Chaitanya also told, because Nityananda Prabhu is a little restless, he is very intoxicated with Krishna Prema. He doesn't know what is day, what is night like that. He will see crocodiles and he will also jump and go with the crocodiles like that. People will be scared because crocodiles are dangerous. So, he will do that in Ganges. So someone has to pull him back. Don't go, there are crocodiles. Oh, there are crocodiles. I don't know. Like that, he was such a, what you call, innocent kind of person. Very, very merciful. He wanted to give mercy to even the crocodiles like that. So Nityananda Prabhu used to go. So it's very difficult to actually depend on Nityananda Prabhu to preach. So that is why Lord Chaitanya actually assigned Haridas Thakur to go with Nityananda Prabhu. Because Haridas Thakur, you know, he's called the Namacharya. He used to chant how many times?
192 rounds.
64 into 3. 192 rounds of Hare Krishna mantra every day. One round we chant and say, Abba, over today. Right? But he used to chant 192 rounds. Right? Those who were initiated 16 rounds, we chant, Yara kaam ho gaya, I'm done, I'm done today. I've taken the oath to chant 16 rounds and follow 480 but he used to chant 192 rounds. He's called Namacharya, right? So he was a very mature creature. So Nityananda Prabhu was very restless. He will walk like this and he will see one bar, he will go inside. He is intoxicated, he will go inside and when it comes out, all of them will come out. Then because they know that, hey, what brand of intoxication are you taking? You are more intoxicated than me. Give me that brand also, I will also drink the same thing. So come, chant Hare Krishna, you will also get high. Right? So he used to get all the people out of the bar. Right? So that is his mood actually, he was always like that. So they both actually joined together and were preaching in Bengal. Normally all the peaceful families, please chant Hare Krishna. What they will do is, first they will go and then approach. If they are very peaceful, they will turn, please chant Hare Krishna. They will also respect them. Then they become devotees. In some places, they will go, knock, nobody will be there. When the person comes and opens out, nobody will be there. Then again, they will knock, they will open the door, nobody will be there. Again they knock. Suddenly somebody opened their legs. Actually they were paying obeisances. Nityananda Prabhu and Haridas Thakur used to pay obeisances to the householders. Please chant Hare Krishna. Can you please chant Hare Krishna? Like that in the very begging mood they used to actually tell their family, please chant Hare Krishna, if they are arrogant people. Looking at this, their heart used to melt. Somebody comes, like such an elderly person is coming, falling at my feet and asking me to chant Hare Krishna. He said, Hare Krishna, please don't get up. Right? So that's how they used to preach. Nityananda Prabhu was getting bored. You do all these things. So they were walking like this and they sought two notorious people. They were Jagai and Madai. They were actually born in Brahmana families. They were not ordinary, normal people. One of them is called Jagadananda and Madhavananda. They were nice people, but they became Bhai. Jagai Bhai, Madhai Bhai, like that. Horrible people. They used to actually drink full tight, full day. And they used to go and then kill people. Whoever comes and tortures them or comes and talks to them, they will kill them. They will plunder. You tell everything, they will do. You do whatever. Meat eating, intoxication, illicit sex, gambling, anything. Even Yamaraj and the Chitragupta. Yamaraj was very scared. What kind of people are these people? In their Yamaraj was actually surprised. Offering they are going to do, don't worry. Yamaraj was surprised because normally somebody will do a sinful activity, no? You know these are the sinful activity, right? Killing a cow is a sinful activity. Yes. Killing a Brahmana is a sinful activity. Right? Torturing a woman is a sinful activity. All these things are sinful activities. So normally people do all these things, right? Jagannath Maharaj did much more than what Himalaya could think. So many sinful activities they did. In varieties, sometimes they will actually pour all this, the wine and kill them. Sometimes they boil all this and put it in somebody. So it was notoriously dangerous people. So Nityananda Prabhu saw this and said, Haridas, are you thinking what I am thinking? Haridas Thakur, add this wine. What is this? What is you are talking about? See there. Then Haridas said, Jagannath Maharaj, Aya, you will do something and run away. I can't run. They are very dangerous. And you are thinking about, what are you thinking? I want to give them Krishna consciousness. You've gone crazy. I can't actually take this. This is very dangerous. Then Nityananda tells Haridas Thakur, you are actually preaching to all people who are anyway standing Hare Krishna. Then what is the big deal in telling that 100 people are actually anyway standing Hare Krishna and said, I made devotees. If you go on then convert one thorough rowdy and everyone knows Saddam Hussein became chanting Hare Krishna, how many people will be benefited? Everyone will know, no? Right? So that is what I want to do. Then Lord Chaitanya will be glorified. Adhya Bapare, you are very dangerous, don't do this. Nityananda Prabhu said, anyway, I'm going to do, you want to come, you come. Right? So they both go near Jagannath Maharaj. Jagannath Maharaj, as usual, are tight. They're drunk, sitting like this. Then Nityananda Prabhu goes to Jagannath Maharaj and said, can't you please chant Hare Krishna? Jagai sees this and becomes very angry. And Madai, both of them sees angry. And they start, mad, pagal sannyasis you are actually coming behind me, right? So, wait, we'll come and kill you. So they have started running, but because they are drunk, they don't know how to run. They're going this side, that side. But then, Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda Prabhu and Haridas Thakur escape. Haridas Thakur goes and tells Lord Chaitanya, from tomorrow onwards, I'm not going. This pagal, I can't go with him. He's crazy. He's going and telling all Jagannath Maharaj kind of people to be delivered. Then Lord Chaitanya says, wow, it's nice. He starts smiling. Then immediately he remembers that means Jagannath Maharaj is going to get delivered. Because Nityananda Prabhu started thinking. Because once the Lord decides to deliver someone, nobody can stop them. They will get liberated. They will get delivered for sure. Next day, again they go there. And this time, Nityananda Prabhu is determined. I am going to deliver him for sure. Nityananda Prabhu and Haridas Thakur go there. Haridas Thakur goes one, two steps behind only. The moment they actually become angry, he will run away like that. Because Haridas Thakur is lowered. Nityananda Prabhu goes, Hare Krishna, please chant Hare Krishna. You will be forgiven of all the sins and worship Lord Chaitanya. This is the order of Lord Chaitanya. Please chant Hare Krishna. Jagai and Madai become very angry. And Madai already is drinking some more wine, takes that pot, throws it at Nityananda Prabhu's head. And it hits Nityananda Prabhu and makes a cut and starts bleeding. It starts starts falling. And Haridas Thakur, I told you, he runs, goes back to report to Lord Chaitanya. And when that's happening, Nityananda Prabhu is not moving. He's standing there and then, please chant Hare Krishna. I'm okay. I pardon. It's fine. Please chant Hare Krishna. And Madai becomes more angry. He takes another pot. He's about to hit him. Jagai stops him. Jagai tells him, hey, these sannyasis, why are you actually disturbing them? You should not actually disturb sannyasis like this. You have done already once. You shouldn't do it again. It's very bad of you. When Jagai says this, Madai says, I don't care. That time, Haridas Thakur has already told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that Nityananda Prabhu has been hurt because he went there to preach to Jagannath Maharaj. And Lord Chaitanya with his whole battalion comes. And when he's coming, he's calling Chakra, Chakra. He's calling Sudarshana. Come, please come. And Sudarshana is following. He's not able to come. He's scared because this particular Kali Yuga, Lord Chaitanya is not supposed to use this weapon. Otherwise, he'll chop everyone. All of us are demons in some sense. Sometimes we are devotees. We feel like Prahlad. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. We chant like as if, wow, such a wonderful devotee. And other times and all, if we are always thinking about how do I exploit the situation, what can I do for myself, Krishna is there in the altar, you'll be happy, okay. I already offered him. Right? I have to think about what I should do next, right? So we are in that mood. So Lord Chaitanya was very, very clear. And Nityan Prabhu, when Lord Chaitanya came, Nityan Prabhu was bleeding and Lord Chaitanya became very angry. Who hit you? And Avalokan said, Madai. And Lord Chaitanya wanted to take the chakra and Nityan Prabhu fell at Lord Chaitanya's feet. My Lord, this is not the time for you to actually kill anyone. You came here to deliver everyone. And how can you kill Madai? You cannot. You should give your mercy to him. And when that happened, Jagai immediately fell at the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya and said, please forgive me. And in fact, Nityan Prabhu told Lord Chaitanya, Jagai actually stopped him from hitting me again. Then Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced Jagai. Thank you for actually protecting my Lord Nityananda Prabhu. When that happened, when Lord Chaitanya actually embraced Jagai, Jagai's hair started standing on end. He got Krishna Prema. He became mad. He started understanding what who is he. He became very happy, excited so much and started chanting Hare Krishna because Lord Chaitanya bestowed Krishna Prema on him. Madai saw all these things. We both did everything together. What is this, yaar? This is not okay. Lord, please, forgive me also. Lord Chaitanya said, you are an offender. If Nityananda Prabhu wants to actually forgive you, then I might forgive you. But otherwise, I will not. You are forbidden from this creation. Nityananda Prabhu immediately sees Madai and embraces Madai. And Madai falls at his feet, he immediately embraces Madai. And Madai starts crying. And immediately, because Nityananda Prabhu forgives him, Lord Chaitanya embraces Madai also. And both of these devotees, they become devotees now, Jagai and Madai. And when both of them actually embrace Lord Chaitanya like this, all their sinful reactions goes to Lord Chaitanya. And Lord Chaitanya's body is what color? Golden. It is called Gauranga. Gauranga. Golden color becomes pitch dark. Black. And all of the devotees surrounding him get scared looking at him. What happened to him? Then Lord Chaitanya closes his eyes and says, chant Hare Krishna, chant Hare Krishna. All of them loudly chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. When they are chanting like that, his body transforms again back to golden. And Lord Chaitanya warns everyone, don't, all these offenses are there in the air. Whenever you do a Vaishnava apra, this will all come to you. All the sins will come to you. So all of them get scared. So we should be careful not to commit Vaishnava aparadha. Right? That's how Jagai and Madai were actually delivered. Not because of Lord Chaitanya, because of Nityananda Prabhu. That is why even in our houses, there are sometimes mini demons are there. Small demons. They're not very powerful, but then sometimes they'll, why are you chanting Hare Krishna? You're supposed to do when you're dying. Right? What are you trying to do? Right? They become very angry at us. So we should pray to Nityananda Prabhu. Sometimes our spouse don't allow or our in-laws don't allow, right? Our children becomes wild. So you pray to Lord Nityananda Prabhu and when you pray to Lord Nityananda Prabhu and ask for blessings, he makes everyone in the family devotees of the Lord. That's his power. Nityananda Prabhu is very powerful. Actually, in fact, when Lord Chaitanya rejects, Nityananda Prabhu accepts. In fact, when Lord Chaitanya came to the South India, he brought one servant with him. His name is Kale Krishnadas. This Kale Krishnadas was a very innocent person. Very, very simple person. So he used to come along with Lord Chaitanya in the south, right? So when he came to this area of Kerala, they were these Bhattadaris. These Bhattadaris were very, very powerful Shakta worshippers. Lord Shiva and Parvati worshippers. They were intoxicated and with women. So Lord Chaitanya just ignored them. But this Bhattadari didn't know what to do. So they actually took him to a place and started feeding him some kind of a intoxicant. So when they, like bhang kind of stuff, so when he took that, he was very, and he was actually completely intoxicated and he was a lot of women and things like that. Lord Chaitanya caught his shikha and dragged him out of that place. Come with me. He dragged him and when he actually went to Jagannath Puri, he dropped him there. Saying that he dumped him. I don't want this kind of a servant. You will keep it. We don't want him. I reject him. So Nityananda Prabhu saw this and he was actually crying Krishnadas. He was a very innocent fellow. So he was crying, and Nityananda Prabhu said, Lord Chaitanya rejected, no, I have not rejected you. You come, I will, you please go to Navadvip and inform Shachi Mata that your son Lord Chaitanya has actually come to Jagannath Puri. So that way Nityananda Prabhu accepted him, even though Lord Chaitanya rejected him, and he continued to remain servant of Nityananda Prabhu for the rest of his life. Right? So that's so wonderful of Nityananda Prabhu to accept, even if Lord Chaitanya rejects, Nityananda Prabhu does not. He'll always accept him, accept the devotees. So 6:20, okay, one last question. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, who wrote the Chaitanya Charitamrita, he's a grand disciple. He's not a disciple of Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya's disciple is Raghunath Das Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami's disciple is Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. He wrote the Chaitanya Charitamrita, past tense of Lord Chaitanya. So he tells, actually I am very, very fallen. I am like a, I am worse than a worm in a stool. Wow, what a comparison. You know, worm in a stool. Somebody has this stomach problem, you get worms in the stool. Very gross, not for discussion. But this Kaviraj Goswami is telling, I am worse than, I am lower than a worm in a stool. Jagai and Madai are very great personalities, because Jagai and Madai are glorified as devotees of Lord Chaitanya. But I am so bad, I am so bad, I am worse than a worm in a stool. And if somebody takes my name and tells Krishnadasa Kaviraja Goswami, he becomes the worst sinner. Imagine the humility. So this is actually the mood of Vaishnavas. They always feel very humble. Whatever is our position, we should always feel that we are not qualified to chant Hare Krishna. It's because of the Panchatattva, it's because of Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda Prabhu that they are allowing us to chant the holy name of the Lord. Otherwise we are unqualified to chant the holy name of the Lord. So in that attitude, we should always chant the holy name. When you are chanting Hare Krishna, we should actually have that mentality. If you have that mentality, remember the Lord all the time. And in that mentality, you chant Hare Krishna, the Lord will accept it as an offering. Otherwise, you are very proud. You are very proud and your chanting is more or less like a parrot. Parrot chanting, you know, like Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. You can chant. But then when the cat comes now, that's all it will do. It will not be able to chant Hare Krishna. So you have to be understanding that. You will not get any realization if you don't chant in that humility. Right? The humility is most important. That mentality of chanting that I am the servant of Krishna is very, very important. And in that mood, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is telling, still I have one qualification. I have surrendered to Lord Nityananda Prabhu. Because of that, I am able to write Chaitanya Charitamrita. So he tells all his followers, we all have to surrender to the Lord. Serve under, put under the lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu. Pray to Nityananda Prabhu saying, my Lord, please accept me as your servant. Please guide me to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and allow me to chant the Hare Krishna mantra. And please make this devotees. My family are there, my dog is not eating, all these things, like, you can actually tell the Lord, please make them all devotees. And all of them will become devotees. It's just a matter of time. Right? So we just have to pray. Today's appearance day, we are celebrating Nityananda Prabhu. Just think of his lotus feet. You can actually see his lotus feet also. Think of his lotus feet always and chant Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. That's all it is. Everything else will actually be taken care of by the Lord. In fact, Prabhupada told, whenever you have a problem, just go to Panchatattva and tell them, I have this problem, my Lord. They will take care. You don't have to actually bother anything. Simply chant Hare Krishna, they will take care of everything else. Nityananda Prabhu ki
Jai.
Nityananda Trayodashi Mahamahotsav ki
Jai.
Varaha Dev Appearance Day ki
Jai.
Nitai Gaur Sitanath Bhimanandi.
Hare
Gaur. Some more time. Any question? Jayan Vijaya said, where are you all going? Everyone was going. Everyone said, I'm coming. Flute said, I'll become the Mridangam. All of them started telling, I'm going with the Lord. Jagan Madhai felt, Jayan Vijaya felt, hey, you are going, why are you leaving me and going? You will also come. Said, okay, you come. You are the worst people you can think of. You also come. So they, Jaya and Vijaya became Jagan Madhai. So they came and then but also the part of the past tense. Actually, in the Parikram Marg in Navadeep, you will find this Madai Ghat. What is Jagai and Madai told? In fact, what I told, I have forgiven all of you. There's a past time there after that. I forget all of you, but don't repeat what you did in the beginning, whatever you are doing before. Right? So, Jagai used to actually wash the feet of Vaishnavas who used to come for taking a bath in Ganga. And they found that Ganga water, if you have been to Ganga somewhere, that the water or the shore is very sticky. It's slippery. It's like very difficult to walk there. So Madai with his own hand dug a ghat, basically a bathing place. He with his own hand did everything so that all the devotees will come, take a bath. When they're going back, he'll fall at their feet and say, "I'm sorry, I actually tortured you or somebody in your family. Please forgive me." So that mentality was very pleasing. The Vaishnavas all blessed them. So he gave this benediction, saying that. So when Jagai and Madai's sin were removed, Yamanas fainted. One full book what Chitragupta had written, everything was gone. They didn't know, like, wow, he's forgive such kind of people, right? In one shot. See, many people take millions of ages to actually atone their sinful reaction. Simply Lord Chaitanya, one shot, he actually removed everything. So it's amazing, right? So that's how Jagai and Madai, Jaya and Vijaya, they appear here to show that the worst people can be delivered. Worst people can be delivered, but the proud people cannot be delivered. If you are very proud that I am from a Brahminical family, I am the beauty queen, I am the most handsome here, I am the CEO of the company, then be happy, Hare Krishna. You will be here only, you will not go anywhere. Right? But if you actually are very humble, even though you are very qualified, you understand that I am unqualified, it's because of Krishna's mercy I am like this. In that attitude you chant Hare Krishna, then you will be delivered. Right? So Jagai Madai actually is the fourth part of Jaya Vijaya. Thank you so much for reminding. So there are so many pastimes like this, you can actually continue, like it can go on and on. Because the Lord's, whenever the Lord appears here, Yada Yada Hi Dharmasya Glahi Bhavati Bharata, he appears here for a reason. And that reason is to deliver all the devotees and kill all the miscreants, right? So that it will be easy for devotees to actually chant Hare Krishna, become devotees, right? Yes? Yeah?
Is it good to recite Nityananda Ashtakam daily, Prabhu?
You can. Shri Gauritai ki jai, Vena Balde Dhrudamai, Sudarshan ki jai. So, we'll get ready for the aarti. I'll just answer this question. Okay. Yes, it's okay to actually chant the Nityananda Ashtakam every day. Yeah, you can, if you know Nityananda Ashtakam, you can chant that. But I mean, mainly you have to chant the Panchatattva mantra. That is Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhara, Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktavanda. Then you can chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So you do this every day, there is no doubt that you'll go back to God. You can see Krishna face to face very soon. It's just a matter of time. Krishna is ready to appear. We are not ready to listen. We are actually saying, the Lord says, surrender unto me, not today, tomorrow. Today I have so many things, okay, you can keep on talking all these things. I have to go home, I have to cook, I have to do this, I have to do that, you know, I have a lot of things. Tomorrow I am getting salary, I have to collect it, I have to go here, there. So we are not ready to surrender. So we are postponing it every day. If you are ready to surrender, the Lord is ready to appear in front of you right now. We are not ready. So take step by step, chant at least one round, two rounds, 16 rounds, whatever you can. Slowly come to a point after accepting Guru. Nityananda Prabhu is actually the Adi Guru. Pray to Nityananda Prabhu. If you don't have a Guru, pray to him. Please guide me. Please give me a Guru. I want to come back to you. Then he will arrange a bona fide Guru for you. Otherwise, we are all devotees of the Lord, but we are not bona fide devotees unless and until we are in the parampara. We are all devotees. Everyone in this creation is devotees. In fact, one Sri Vaishnava saint told me that when Vamanadeva actually touched the three worlds, right? He already has put his feet on everyone's head. So they are already devotees. But we don't recognize that. Till we don't recognize that, we are not considered as bona fide devotees. So when you take shelter of a bona fide spiritual master, we take diksha from him, understand that my life is for you, that point in time, you become very dedicated in the parampara. Then the Lord says, come over. Till that point in time, we are guests. We are guests in the Lord's movement. The Lord also is happy as long as you are serving Him. You stop serving Him, you also say, Hare Krishna, thank you so much. Right? So He's also happy like that. So, but we should actually be dedicated to the Lord. Even if I die, I will not leave the Lord's lotus feet. That mentality you cultivate and pray to Nityananda Prabhu, He will give you a spiritual master for sure. Are we ready for the aarti? Okay. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.